What's the line that white people can start experiencing?
Is that for me?
Yeah.
You can answer it.
Like the, well, I guess it's hard. The line at which white people would have to be in, I'm not really sure I understand the question.
He's asking
how much institutional power.
He's asking
power
how much
would,
less white do you have to be before you can enter into theoretically having perpetuated on you.
If people look at you and perceive you as black or a different race.
What if you have vitiligo?
I think people, you can still easily tell if someone is black with vitiligo.
Okay, just
except checking. Maybe in the case of like people who have extreme cosmetic procedures like Michael Jackson, but there's always going to be fringe cases that are a little weird, but I think everyone can easily perceive race.
But if we're just saying the bad is the bad, because that's what we're just saying here. The bad is the bad. Whatever we perceive as bad and whatever we perceive as bad is what we don't like. Then mm-hmm. If white people say that if you're going after them based on their skin color and they don't like it, then that would be the same exact standard you would appeal to. I don't know how you get around that.
Well, I think there can be things beyond there. I mean, it can be a problem of scale. Like what is more bad? If we're just talking about what's bad, what is more bad? I say that this is more bad. Like if we're really going to reduce it down to that, I think there's
more. Yeah, but
more
I say that that's less bad.
Okay, well then, I mean, what are we even arguing?
That's my whole point. This is the problem when we're going into justifications of what is bad. If it's just the bad is the bad is the bad is the bad. You know what I mean?
Well,
whatever I think is
like
bad
I said,
is bad.
Like I said, I tried to give examples. You're just not going to let me give any sort of like ethical justification that is secular.
I'll let you give any ethical justification you want, which is secular.
Well, no, but you'll call it relativism.
It is relativism.
Okay, well then, I mean, I'm kind of at a, I can't really do anything.
And so if it's relativism, then asking me for any sort of justification is relative. So
Relative to what? I mean,
to
like,
nothing, because that's your justification.
But do you
nothing.
Do you believe, whether you'll give it or not, do you believe you have an objective Christian ethicist justification for what is bad?
Do you, well, if you're making that claim, if you're asking me this question, mm-hmm. Do you believe in objective truth?
I don't think so. No.
Well, then why do you care what my answer would be? Because
genuine curiosity.
Not, no matter what I said, it would not objectively be true in your worldview, right?
I mean, you...
Thank you, Sean. Go ahead.
I just don't... I mean... I know it would not be objectively true, whatever you say in my worldview.
Yeah, whatever I say.
But...
Because there is no standard for which is true. And so that's why we end up with relativism. And so when I tell you that
what's wrong? What's bad about relativism?
Well, here's what's bad about relativism and its reduction. So it works like this. If you have a standard, we both have a worldview. And if I have a standard for truth, that means I need to have something which is an invariant standard, meaning we can apply all standards to it. This would require a standard for knowledge and epistemology. Okay? So your knowledge has to have a standard, and it has to be a standard which has no variant. This is how we know if a thing is true or false. Would you agree with me that the laws of logic, which are required for us to have this debate, are objectively true?
I mean, I'll say yes. I'll say yes. I don't
well,
have to
no,
think about
are
that
they
one.
Or aren't they?
I don't. I really don't know.
You don't know if the laws of logic.
I don't
logic
know if there, I don't know if there is objective truth.
Like,
no.
For instance, the law of non-contradiction. Can you be here in an outer space at the same time?
No. Okay.
Is that objectively a true statement?
Yes.
So, okay. What's your standard for that true statement?
I guess experience and reason.
Experience, like, and reason?
Yeah, I can reason that those things...
But you just got done telling me there's no such thing as objective truth.
Well, no, I'm agreeing with you now. There is...
Now there is a such thing as an objective truth.
I'm always thinking and I'm always learning.
And if there is a standard for objective truth, an invariable standard, which you cannot move away from, right? From your perspective, when we're talking about the laws of logic, you say these are true. Can you justify why we ought to use them?
Everything is argued in that way, same as Christian ethics. Can you justify why we ought to use Christian ethics?
I can, but before I do, I'm trying to show you why the reduction here is wrong.
I would argue that we ought to use secular ethics because it's not based on something that is not real.
But it's subject. No, it is. Because it's all subjective, and yet you just said that there's an objective standard for truth. But why should we have subjective morality if there's an objective standard for truth? If we have an objective standard for truth, wouldn't we want objective morals? Because we know
we know
a thing can now be true, right?
But I don't. But that's the thing. If you can't enforce a system of morals that is based on something that only a fraction of people believe, I mean,
whether you can enforce it or not would not make it less true or false if it was moral, right?
Sure. I guess I just struggle to understand how ethics based on religion, something that not everyone believes, is somehow more objectively true than ethics based
on something that nobody believes.
There's lots of different secular epistemologies. They're all based on different things.
Yeah, but they're based on just relativism. The problem with it is you can't say that yours is better than mine. So asking me for justification for mine's irrelevant. Who cares? No matter what, you're always in the position where it's just as valid as your position. And there's really nothing you can do about that. So asking me endlessly to make a justification for a thing which you have no justification, I'm not trying to convince you that I'm correct, just trying to show you that we're always, always going to be equally justified in whatever it is that we want in society from your own worldview. There's nothing I could do which you could ever point to as being bad because it's just as morally justified as anything you do.
I mean, that's all well and good, but in reality, there's a sense of like moral intuition. And how can you say that?
Moral intuition.
How can you say that like intuition is wrong?
Everybody doesn't have the same moral intuitions.
No, but I think there are certain things that are
like
necrophilia.
If we all had the same moral intuitions, and you think that therefore those are the right morals.
Not everyone has the same, but I think there are general things that we can agree on, and there's always going to be people who...
Then why do we need feminism if we're all just moral people based on our intuitions?
Well, I didn't say that feminism was a moral thing.
So is it immoral?
No, I mean, it's not concerning morals.
Concerning morals?
No, I think it's concerning the way...
So egalitarianism isn't a moral position?
No, I think it's... It's what, well, I don't like not being treated equally.
Yeah. Right. And we can reduce your entire moral epistemology down to, I don't like it, right?
No.
No?
No.
So what like can I we said, reduce intu- it down to?
I mean,
intuition?
My personal, I would intuition. Say it's a combination of intuition, my experiences of the world, mm-hmm. and my ability to think and reason through
things.
But
we all don't share the same intuitions, right?
No, but I mean, there's a reason we have classes of epistemologies. Clearly enough people agree on a certain standpoint that there's a school of it, a school of thought.
For different branches of knowledge. But actually, that would make my point that we don't share the same intuitions, or otherwise there wouldn't be so many different branches.
No, I would
of people who have theories of knowledge, right?
I would agree that. I mean, knowledge is a tough thing to pin down. I don't think anyone can really ever say how we know what we know and what is truth.
We can't, but we just know that there is objective truth by your own admission.
I'm going back and I don't know if there's objective truth. I haven't really thought about it.
So we can be having this conversation and not having this conversation at the same time?
Existence is pretty absurd. I don't know.
No.
It's one of those things.
So existence itself is a contradiction?
It might be.
Yeah.
I don't spend a lot of time.
I won't belabor the point. It feels it's kind of silly to do at this point. But anyway, Brian, do you want to move it on to anything else?
I'll come back in just a second. Okay. You guys keep